Today I'm working on a Husqvarna 350BT. This machine has become difficult to start and then won't start at all. So I'll take you through the process of diagnosing a very common problem on these and we'll get it fixed. I've taken the engine cover off just to make spark testing easier. So we will, with a new spark plug, rest this on metal and see if we can get I see nothing. So with a spark tester installed, see if we get any sparking. We get a good strong orange blinking light, so that's an indication that we're getting impulse from the magneto. So let's see why we're not getting spark at the plug. Let's take this spark plug boot off and see if we can see what's going on in there. A little shot of tri-flow helps things move a little bit. We can push it back and forth a few times. And then extract. So our connections here are good. So let's see if this will spark. It does, but it takes a lot of engine cranking speed to get a spark out of it. So with a spark plug installed, we'll see if it'll start. Go full choke. Couple pumps on the carburetor. So after disturbing the spark plug wire, it now starts on the first pull. And it's very common for these to have a failed magneto, and that will cause them to start well at certain times and not start at all at other times. And we're sort of proving that it's in the ignition coil. To gain access to the ignition coil, we are going to take off the fuel tank. And we'll undo this tab and feed the spark plug wire out. And then we'll remove that screw right there. And slide the electrics out. Unplug the kill wire. And the two screws that hold the coil on. And remove the coil. And time to put the new coil in. Make sure you install it with the spade for the kill wire facing outward. Put the ground wire in. I'm going to get these started by hand first before we tighten them down. That way I don't strip the housing and use a card A business card works well for this. And with our business card holding our gap, we can tighten it up. And then we'll install the remainder of the wiring. There's the kill wire. We'll route the spark plug wire through and use that grommet. That grommet is supplied on the new spark plug wire. It's normally not this fiddly, but I'm working around the camera. Okay, everybody has got a nice bend, no kinks, no interference. We can put the cover back on, take our card out, check the air gap. Here's a close-up of the installation. And if you look up top at the flywheel, you can see the air gap that's created by using the business card, about 0.008". There's a tab on this, so that tucks underneath the engine case. And we can route this spark plug wire back up inside of the carburetor area and underneath our little clamp like that. Here's a close-up of the spark plug wire routing. It goes inside the engine cover. And there's a channel in behind the carburetor that it fits into. It'll be a little bit long, so pull it downward at the bottom of the engine, and then it'll fit cleanly like this. Fuel tank installation. And now a quick test start. Carburetor a few pumps since we had the fuel tank off. Ignition is on. Choke. Now starts on just half a pull. It's actually starting as I'm pulling the rope, where before it would randomly take a dozen pulls, or three or four pulls, or not start at all. Very common with these machines to have a failure of this type in the ignition coil, and that's how to take care of it. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you out.